بسم الله بسم الله.
अब ये वाला माइक है ना, सब में घूमेगा. मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ,
committee members, we welcome all of you for this grand maulid in Rabiul Awal. We'd like to call upon Mr. Yusuf, Haji Yusuf from Sydney, Ahbab al-Mustafa, to open with the recitation of Quran. Please. For the housekeeping, please off your mobile phone and please put to silent, please. Assalamu alaikum.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ما كان على النبي من حرج فيما فرض الله له سنة الله في الذين خلوا من قبل وكان أمر الله قدرا مقدورا الذين يبلغون رسالات الله ويخشونه ولا يخشون أحدا إلا الله وكفى بالله حسيبا ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين وكان الله بكل شيء عليما يا كثيرا وسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا هو الذي يصلي عليكم وكان بالمؤمنين رحيما. وكان بالمؤمنين رحيما تحيتهم يوم يلقونه سلام تحيتهم يوم يلقونه سلام وأعد لهم أجرا كريما. يا وبشر المؤمنين بأن لهم من الله فضلا كبيرا. ولا تطع الكافرين والمنافقين ودع توكل على الله وتوكل على الله وكفى بالله وكيلا. صدق الله العظيم. الفاتحة.
Jazakallah, Sheikh Yusof. Sheikh Yusof is from Sydney, the Ahbab al-Mustafa group that travels over here for our Maulid this year. We'd like to call upon Sheikh Imam Ibrahim Hasanovic, who is the Imam of Australian Bosnian Islamic Center, who is the main committee who organizes Maulid today. And we hope that his speech will enlighten us a little bit. And he was supposed to do Qasida in Bosnian, but he will do it. I was told that he declined, but he will do it, inshallah. Tafadhal, Sheikh. Sheikh, you need to use this live telecast.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My respectable brother Afifuddin Jilani, dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm touched by this recitation of the Holy Quran, and as I'm not the main speaker here tonight, I'm very happy because I just want to say a couple of words from my heart. I came here from Bosnia 2 years ago, and when I see all these beautiful faces here in nice clothes from all around the world joining together only because of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we came here to show our love and respect towards our beloved Prophet, and I'm so happy and honored to have you all brothers and sisters here. May Allah reward you for coming. May Allah increase our love towards Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I wish you all to enjoy in this gathering here. A special thanks for our brothers from Sydney. They will, inshallah, make us heart crying today in this beautiful mosque. And I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we all benefit from this gathering, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who love each other for the sake of Allah, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us be amongst those who are following the path, the footstep of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I just want to share with you information because you don't know, in Bosnia we have a very strong connection with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have many mosques and many tekiyas and many places to worship, and also our people following different types of tariqa. We have Naqshbandi tariqa there, we have Qadiri tariqa, we have Halveti tariqa, and many other tariqa in Bosnia. So for centuries our people are unique in love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So I'm very happy, and may Allah reward you all. I hope that this gathering will just be tiny glimpse of our next, inshallah, meetings, collaborationships between our communities. May Allah reward you all for coming. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Is it working?
Naređeno slušajmo i milosti hitajmo, naređeno slušajmo i milosti hitajmo, ko bulbuli učimo, Allah, Allah recimo. Ko bulbuli učimo, Allah, Allah recimo.
Allah mi govorimo, iz srca ga volimo. Allah mi govorimo, iz srca ga volimo. Dok u tmini živimo, Allah, Allah recimo. Dok u tmini živimo, Allah, Allah recimo. Kad u kabur stignemo i pitani budemo, kad u kabur stignemo i pitani budemo, tvoj gospodar ko je to, Allah, Allah recimo. Tvoj gospodar ko je to, Allah, Allah recimo. Yunus reče stihove, Allah su mu sve želje. Yunus reče stihove, Allah su mu sve želje. Ugledati mu lice, Allah, Allah recimo. Ugledati mu lice, Allah, Allah recimo.
Of course, of course. No worries. Just tell me.
Thank you. No worries. We'd like to call upon Asayid Sheikh Fifuddin Al-Jilani to give a token of appreciation to Ibrahim, Imam Ibrahim Hasanovic.
I'm embarrassed. We have nothing for you.
And this is also a poster.
Yeah.
We made it in it's a 3D poster.
Allah, Allah.
We made it in Malaysia in our celebration last year.
Mashallah.
So we printed and we give as a gift.
May Allah reward.
So Alhamdulillah.
May Allah reward.
This poster was from the Maulid last year in Kuala Lumpur, and Sheikh Fifuddin is giving this as a token for the Boston Islamic Council.
May Allah reward you, brother. May Allah reward you.
Alhamdulillah. Yes, can put this. Take the chair. May Allah reward you. Jazakallah, Sheikh. Oops,
no, no, no.
It's too light.
Wait.
I'll give this to my father. Yeah. Who's now next? Yeah. Thank you, Shay. We'd like to call Brother Tariq Mansour to give his Urdu Naat. Please, tafadhal. We have an international language today in our performing of Maulid. Tafadhal, Shay.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, much privileged, very lucky to be part of this ceremony. It is a mix of Urdu and Arabic nasheed. So I would request if you can please join me in reciting the salawat on our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's a typical tone of Pakistani culture to recite the salawat. And then I will, inshallah, represent another small nasheed.
Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammadin. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallim. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin. Mere Mustafa, mere Mujtaba, mere Mustafa, mere Mujtaba, Shah Haseen aaya na aayega, Shah Haseen aaya na aayega, unhein dekhna ho jo khwab mein, unhein dekhna ho jo khwab mein, to durud un par pada karo. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina wa maulana wa ala alihi sahbihi wa barik wa sallim. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina sarwar kahun ke malik o maula kahun tujhe sarwar kahun ke tujhe baaghe khaleel ka gule zeba kahun tujhe. Allahumma salli sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadin. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina na Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallim. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And now those few lines, can I please request to recite with me, Ya Ayyuhal Muzzammilu.
Ya Ayyuhal Muzzammilu, 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 Ya Ayyuhal Muzzammilu. Ae Mursale Paakiza Khu, Is khulq ka peker hai tu, Qur'an hai أيها المزمل يا أيها المزمل يا أيها المزمل تو كائنات حسن ہے تیری زکات حسن ہے تو کائنات حسن ہے تیری زکات حسن ہے یہ آب و گل یہ رنگ و بو یا ایوہ المزمل یا ایوہ المزمل یا ایوہ المزمل چہرہ تیرا تکتا رہوں تجھ سے تیری باتیں سنوں چہرہ تیرا تکتا رہوں تجھ سے تیری باتیں سنوں رکھتا ہوں میں یہ آرزو یا ایوہ المزمل یا ایوہ المزمل یا ایوہ اے مرسل پاکیزہ تو اس خلق کا پیکر ہے تو قرآن ہے گویا ہو بہو یا ایوہ المزمل یا ایوہ المزمل یا ایوہ المزمل صلى الله عليه وسلم
I'd like to call upon Sheikh Fifuddin to present his token of appreciation to Brother Tariq Mansur. Brother Tariq Mansur. Please. Alhamdulillah, from Bosnia we went to Pakistan. Now we have to come back to Australia. However, we have a true blue Lebanese brothers, the first Australian Habab al-Mustafa, the best, among the best. And we don't want to miss any much time, so we like to call upon our Habab al-Mustafa under the guidance of Sheikh Azam Mastro, who is not here. May Allah be pleased and well with him. We like them to perform this Qasida. She, they like you to pass them a flower first of the position.
She, Ibrahim, you want to take photograph there?
Yeah, of
there's some more mic here. More mic, Sultan? Mic, my mic? Yeah, Habibi. This one also.
Assalamu
Bismillah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا مولانا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وأصحابه وعلى إخوانه الأنبياء والمرسلين. اللهم ربنا تقبل منا واقبلنا وتب علينا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا بسر نبيك العظيم وبسر أسرى سورة الفاتحة.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي.
الحمد لله.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
Seven.
قد انحصرت به المكارم كلها قد انحصر به المكارم كلها ولكن ندى كفيه ليس له حصر وأفضل منك يا طه لم ترى قط عين وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء وأفضل منك يا حبيب الله لم ترى قط عين وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب وكأنك يا حبيبي خلقت كما تشاء
اللهم صل عليه يا سيدي
خلقت مبرأ من كل عيب وكأنك يا رسول الله خلقت كما تشاء صلى الله على محمد
صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد
لا لا لا
لم صلى الله على محمد
صلي عليه
We want to say it at the roof of the masjid, inshallah, Allah is the Medina, bismillah ta'ala.
Sallallahu ala Muhammad,
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sallallahu ala Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Aqbal al-Badru alina min thaniyat al-wada. الشكر علينا ما دعا إلا إذا
صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
هذه الدنيا تزول والبقاء ليس يطول كل من يمشي يقول كن شفعنا يا محمد
صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
يا حبيبي يا محمد يا طبيبي يا ممجد أنت ذو الفضل المؤيد جل من سلم عليك
صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
صلوا عليه صلوا عليه
طه النبي صلوا عليه صلوا عليه صلوا عليه طه النبي صلوا عليه صلوا عليه صلوا عليه اللهم صل عليه صلوا عليه صلوا عليه اللهم صل عليه
لما نظرت إلى أنواره
سطعت
وضعت من خفتي كفي على بصري
لما نظرت إلى أنواره سطعت وضعت من خفتي كفي على بصري
خوفي على بصري، خوفا على بصري من حسن صورته، خوفا على بصري من حسن صورته، فلست أنظره إلا على قدر روح من النور في جسم من القمر، روح من النور في جسم من القمر، كحلة نسجت في الأنجوم الزهور في الربيع الأول ولد المفضل، والزمان أقبل بالنبي المضلل في ربيع الأول ولد المفضل، والزمان والزمان أقبل بالنبي المضلل في ربيع الأول ولد المفضل، والزمان أقبل بالنبي المضلل، صلوا عليه صلوا عليه طه النبي، صلوا عليه صلوا عليه صلوا عليه، اللهم صل عليه صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم،
صلى الله عليه
صلى
The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the stingy one is the one when I'm mentioned in his presence and he does not send salutations upon me. So I send salutations to the Messenger on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so he can reach the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
ولد الهدى فالجنة ضياء، ولد الهدى فالجنة ضياء، وفم السمايا تبسم وفناء، الروح والملك الملائك حوله للدين والدنيا به بشرى، يا رب بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا، يا رب بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم، اسمع مدح طه وافهم كلام الله، يا المحب نعطيك أكبر علامة، الله اسمع مدح طه واسمع كلام الله، يا المحب نعطيك أكبر علامة، تلقى النبي واقف يوم القيامة،
والليلة عندكم عيد يا أحبابي مولد رسول الله خير البرية والليلة عندكم عيد يا أحبابي مولد رسول الله خير البرية حي قيوم الله حي قيوم الله حي قيوم الله حي قيوم الله يا زائر المصطفى سلم عليه مهندس والعمر كله شمت بإيديه يا زائر المصطفى سلم عليه مهندس والعمر كله شمت إيديه حمزي حي قيوم الله حي قيوم الله
اطرب اطرب يا محب لا لوم علينا لا تبالي بالعزال والمنكرين
اطرب اطرب يا محب لا لوم علينا لا تبالي بالعزال والمنكرين قيوم الله 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 يا دايم الله 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 والدايم الله 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 يا دايم الله 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 والدايم الله
جود بالوصال يا من هجر قال
جود بالوصال يا من هجر قال
كيف يكون الحال بوصالكم الله
الله الله الله
وحد المولى
الله 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 يا دايم الله 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 والدايم الله 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 يا دايم الله 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 والدايم الله
يا قلبي سلم الله
الله
فهو المعطي المانع
الله
ورضى بقضاء الله
الله
إنا لله راجعون
الله
ماذا في علم الله الخيرة في الواقع الله
الله الله الله الله الله يا دايم الله 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 والدايم الله 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 يا دايم الله 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 والدايم الله
ربي فانظر لي
يا
تجلى علينا
الله
ربي فانظر لي
الله
تجلى علينا
الله
بجاهنا
صلي عليه الله 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 يا دايم الله 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 والدايم الله 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 يا دايم الله 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 والدايم الله
ولا ظل له بل كان نورا
الله الله يكن الهدى لولا ظهورا
وكل الكون أنار بنور
صلي عليه
قمر
قمر قمر سيدنا النبي قمر وجميل 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 سيدنا النبي وجميل
وكف المصطفى كالورد نادي
الله الله
وعطرها يبقى إذا مست أياني
الله الله
وكف المصطفى كالورد نادي
الله الله
وعطرها يبقى إذا مست
أياني أكلنا بها يا رب الله الله
وعم نوالها كل العباد
وعم نوالها كل العباد وعم نوالها كل العباد حبيب الله يا خير البراء
يا
قمر 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 سيدنا النبي قمر وجميل سيدنا النبي وجميل
يا أهل المدينة فين نروح بحالنا وظلم كما عادي فرج كامنا بالله قولوا للحبيب المصطفى يعطف علينا بالله مقبالنا
يا أهل المدينة فين نروح بحالنا وضربك ما عادي فرج كربنا لله قولوا للحبيب المصطفى يعطف علينا بالله بكبادنا
رحوا المدينة وصلوا باب السلام شموا المسك والطيب من ذاك المقام راحوا المدينة وصلوا باب السلام
الله الله
شموا المسك والطيب من ذاك المقام يا مسعد الزوار قد نالوا المرام نحن الظلام الليل نسكب دمعنا
أهل المدينة فيننا روح بحالنا والله البكا ما عاد يفرج قلبنا بالله قولوا للحبيب المصطفى يعطف علينا من الله بكبادنا
يا أهل الطيبة بالجوار تنعموا منوا علينا ومن عطاكم أنعموا يا أهل الطيبة بالجوار تنعموا منوا علينا ومن عطاكم أنعموا زوار طه عدى لا نتعودوا نحن إله الكون يعلم حالنا
يا أهل المدينة فين نروح بحالنا والله البكا ما عاد يفرد قلبنا بالله قولوا للحبيب المصطفى يعطف علينا بالله بكبادنا اشتقنا لك اشتقنا لك اشتقنا يا خي الملقاها سكن المدينة محلاها طه بنوار بسما سكن المدينة محلاها طه بنوار بسما اشتقنا لك اشتقنا لك اشتقنا يا خي الملقاها إني أحب محمدا والله خير شهيدا يا ربي صل على المدى أبدا عليه مجددا إني أحب محمدا والله خير شهيدا يا ربي صل على المدى أبدا عليه مجددا
ودوني من نبي
ودوني إليه أنا هايم به صلى الله عليه ودوني للنبي ودوني إليه أنا هايم به صلى الله عليه والله
ترى الأنوار
يلا
عليه
ودوني للنبي ودوني إليه أنا هايم به صلى الله عليه ودوني للنبي ودوني إليه أنا هايم به صلى الله عليه صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله
عليه
وسلم صلى الله
عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على
صلى على الحبيب
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said, which one means, whoever sends one salutation upon me, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send upon him 10. In another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, whoever sends upon me 10 salutations, then Allah will send upon him 100. And whoever sends upon me 100, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send upon him 1,000. And whoever sends upon me 1,000 salutations, then Allah has forbidden Jahannam on eating his flesh and his skin and his hair. So send salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sallallahu ala Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu ala Muhammad.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
MashaAllah.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah 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 Allah
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam
الله الله
عليك صلى الله يا خير لجلاك بكل الكون والله يعلو الدجال يوم الحشر يلقى كل محن يترجال لما ستشفع عند مولانا مثلك ما ينوجد مثلك قلبي لجلاك بكل الكون والله يا عيوني بكل الكون والله يا حبيبي ما نقدر نوصف طه ما مهما نقول فاق الحلس المحبوب تعدى المعمول على ذي الأمة الهادي واقف المسؤول سجد وينادي رحمة للإنس وجاني
يلي توصف على هونك صدق غلطان يلي توصف على هونك صدق غلطان ماكم جمال الهادي من إنس وجاني يلي توصف على هونك صدق غلطان يلي توصف على هونك صدق غلطان ماكم جمال الهادي من إنس
وجاني هذا محمد محبوب رحمة للناس هذا الطبيب اللي يذهب عنا
الوسواس
هذا جميل
الطلعة ومنع الوداس
شاهد آيات القدرة نجد ديان
يلي توصف على هونك صدق غلطان يلي توصف على هونك صدق غلطان ماكم جمال الهادي من إنس وجاني يلي توصف على هونك صدق غلطان يلي توصف على هونك صدق غلطان ماكم جمال الهادي من إنس وجاني
طلع البدر علينا
من ثاني الوداع
غلب الشكر علينا نادى لله داع أيها المبعوث فينا جئت بالأمر المطاع جئت المدينة مرحبا يا خير داع
وذلك في ليلة الاثنين
وذلك في ليلة الاثنين من بعد العشاء إلى طلوع لمعت الفجرية فأخذها المقام ووضعته صلى الله عليه وسلم نور يتلألأ كالبدر ليلة التمام
الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليكم يا أنبياء الله أجمعين اللهم صل وسلم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد عدد خلقك ورضا نفسك وزينة عرشك ومداد كلماتك بك كلما ذكرك الذاكرون وغفل عن ذكرك الغافلون
فاعلم أنه لا
سلام عليك يا رسول سلام عليك تسکین سے روتے ہوئے ہنس پڑے جس کی تسکین سے روتے ہوئے ہنس پڑے اس تبسم کی عادت پہ لاکھوں سلام مصطفیٰ جانِ رحمت
شفاعت زہرا
سلام شمع بزم
حد جس سمت اٹھے غنی کر دیا ہاتھ جس سمت اٹھے غنی کر دیا ہاتھ جس سمت اٹھے غنی کر دیا موجے بہرے سخاوت پہ
لاکھوں سلام مصطفیٰ جان رحمت تیلا
سلام شمع بزم
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين
صل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين صل على سيدنا محمد حتى ترث الأرض ومن عليها وأنت خير الوارثين ربنا تقبل منا وقبلنا وبارك في أحوالنا وأقوالنا وأفعالنا وأزواجنا وذرياتنا وارض عنا بما رضيت به عن عبادك الصالحين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم بارك لنا في أحوالنا وأقوالنا وأفعالنا وأزواجنا وذرياتنا في جمعنا في مجلسنا في ليلتنا في شهرنا المبارك هذا اللهم اجعلنا في شهرنا هذا المبارك من المتقربين إلى حضرة حبيبك سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اجعل حبه في قلوبنا وحبنا في قلبه الشريف وارزقنا الله شفاعته يوم القيامة وارزقنا الكريم صحبته يوم القيامة اللهم لا تحرمنا شفاعته ولا زيارته في الدارين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار صل وسلم وبارك على حبيبك ورسولك سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الحمد لله رب العالمين
Can we settle down, all of us, please?
That was Ahbab al-Mustafa from Sydney with Brother Muhammad Al, who has transformed Bosnian mosque into totally a different area now. Imam Ibrahim Hasanovic has a different time now.
May Allah reward you, brother.
Are you going? You leave? Make dua for my son, please. Just salam to your father. We'll keep in touch on the phone. We go to Perth on the 22nd. Yeah, yeah. You're going, Habibi? You take dua for my son. Send salam to your father, please.
May he give some shifa.
Allah, please, shifa.
Allah give him shifa.
Amen. Make dua for him.
Allah, you made me upset.
Allah. I love all of you. Shafiq will be here, he'll be very happy. But he watched live.
I'm gonna call him.
Please, yes. Please. This is all right. This is all right. JazakAllah, happy to see you again. Sure. Sure. We'll see you soon. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi sayyidina Muhammad. Alhamdulillah, the month of Rabiul Awal is so special. In this blessed month that Allah Ta'ala grant us his creations the greatest gift, the greatest favors that no other creations, not even the jinns and all the prophets alayhi salatu wasalam, has attained. The gift of rahmatil alamin, the birth of his special and most loving creation, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah's blessings be upon him and salutations all upon him continuously. And blessings upon blessings upon all of us today. We congratulate all of you, the organizers, the Australian Bosnian Islamic Center Committee, and every each and individual who have made this possible by being here or following this program on live telecast all over the world. Because present among us today is the family of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are so blessed. His Excellency Al-Sheikh As-Said Afifuddin Al-Jilani, may Allah protect him and elevate the maqam, amin. Sheikh, may I humbly present and introduce a little of your biography and work that you have done, please. Al-Sheikh As-Said Afifuddin Al-Jilani was born in Iraq in 1972 and is the 19th direct descendant of the most prominent Islamic scholar, Al-Sheikh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani. Sheikh Afifuddin is the 33rd direct descendant of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sheikh Afifuddin specialized in fiqh, sharia laws and tasawuf. Among his great teacher was the late Mufti of Iraq, Allahyarham, Sheikh Abdul Karim Al-Mudarris, rahmatullahu alaik, where he was conferred the Ilmiah of Alim. As the head of the founder of Darul Jalani International, Sheikh Afifuddin is closely involved in organizing regular teachings and educational classes, public lectures and forums at national and international level. These are organized and conducted according to the best practice of traditional Islamic learning and with added benefits of modern techniques. Spreading and sharing messages of peace, tolerance, love, care and understanding to all and among almighty creations, as this is the real message of Islam, peace. All lectures are actually live on his Facebook. It's available. If it's not live, it's recorded. Sheikh Afifuddin is constantly engaged in these activities for the Ummah in many countries on a regular basis. As for now, we have him for 9 months. We are blessed. Because of certain situation, he's with us until March. So we are able to have him in all the mosques. And we hope that one day he will give his khutbah in this mosque, inshallah. He travels to Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia, Brunei, Australia, of course, New Zealand, Fiji, Sri Lanka, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Egypt, Jordan, United Arab Emirates, Denmark, Sweden, Swiss, Canada, United States of America. May I request all of us, please lend our ears and attention as I humbly call upon and proudly present all of us His Excellency Al-Sheikh Sayyid Afifuddin Al-Jilani to guide and share us his words of wisdom. Tafadhal mashkura ya Sheikh.
والتمكين الذي أحسن كل شيء خلقه وبدأ خلق الإنسان من طين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين وإمام المتقين ورحمة الله للعالمين سيدنا ومولانا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد صلاة ترضيك وترضيه وترضى بها عنا في شهرنا هذا في ليلتنا هذه في مسجدنا هذا في جمعنا هذا بما رضيت به عن عبادك الصالحين ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي الحمد لله وذ الله بركة سبحانه وتعالى We've been blessed to be here at this blessed masjid Australian Bosnian Islamic Center Jazakumullah khair. Thank you so much, Imam Ibrahim and all the committee for hosting this program to share with all of us the love of Al-Habib al-Mustafa Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As we say, the first month in an Islamic calendar is the month of Al-Muharram. And the first month in a Gregorian calendar is January. But the first month in the calendar of Muhibbin is Rabi'ul Awwal. So may Allah grant us the true and pure love to Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And through this love, we will be with him insha'Allah in Jannah. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. So Jazakumullah khair. Thank you so much for our brothers and sisters. Many of them came from many places in Victoria and from just now also from Sydney, Ahbab al-Mustafa, Jazakumullah khair, from Shepparton, other places. And the saying, al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, al-ajr ala qadr al-mashaqqa, which means the reward depends on how struggle you are. But we say today, al-ajr ala qadr al-mahabba, the reward depends on love, alhamdulillah. So inshallah, with Allah's barakah, we will see this unity always in our life. Within our houses, our workplaces, schools, masjids, and everywhere, spread the message of peace. The only message of Islam, which is a beautiful message, the message of peace. There is no other message than that message. And all of us, inshallah, will play this important role in our life to do so, inshallah. We ask Allah to bless us, to be the door which open all the door, to be the hand which open all the doors of good deeds. And the same hand, inshallah, will close all the door of evil deeds. Bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by following the sunnah al-Habib al-Mustafa Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have sent him as a mercy to all worlds. Wa ma arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil'alameen. Inshallah, we will present this rahmah by our actions, attitude, behavior, everywhere, so the people knows that we are the true lovers of Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So alhamdulillah, it's Allah's barakah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be here together to celebrate this barakah. And inshallah, our theme for tonight will be celebrating our beloved, uniting our hearts. We are in a deep need for this unity because all of us share for sure. Or let us, they might be differences between all of us in terms of cultures, from where we came, other things. But for sure, we share together the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All of us share these words. And just now, our dear brother Imam Ibrahim have recited at the beginning of the majlis a little bit of poem in Bosnian. Maybe our ear cannot understand the meaning, but for sure our hearts felt that meaning. Insha'Allah. This is a place where Allah looking to. And when Allah see in your heart this love to anything make you close to him subhanahu wa ta'ala and to his beloved prophet Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the time where your level will be increased inshallah, a level of iman. Alhamdulillah, this is Allah's barakah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are celebrating today. In fact, we should celebrate every day, each moment, celebrate al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whenever we face the Qibla, we celebrate him. Whenever we pray 5 times, this is also a celebration. When we go to Hajj, when he gives zakah, when we deal with our family. Remember all these ahadith, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is always a beautiful saying of him to enlighten our life, to be always the best, not to be good, to be the best. Because he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our example, وَلَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. He's our great and excellent example, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, we are representing him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If a good Muslim, the best Muslim is the best Muslim in his moral character. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Quran is the only one time said about akhlaq, moral character, mentioned about it in one time only, in one place, in Surah Noon, in Surah Al-Qalam, verse 4. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, wa innaka la'ala khuluqin azim. Akhlaq. Says that, Ya Rasulullah, you have a high standard of moral character. Even the ulama, Ahl al-Tafsir, when they come to translate that, to interpret that meaning, in Arabic, la'ala khuluqin, alaz mean tufidu al-fawqiyya, al-ulu. يعني يا رسول الله, you are above الخلق, you are above moral character. You are higher than that, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Because he, as we said, he represents all good moral and all the beautiful and excellent moral characters in our life. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about akhlaq in Quran, and he said, يا رسول الله, you are the one who has the excellent moral character, that mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want us to see his quality of akhlaq sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and adopt it in our life. It's not enough for us just to face Qibla, to say how many number of times we pray and how many number of times we go to Hajj and how much we give zakah. That's all important. But there is always a message comes out from this masjid. That message goes to our houses, goes to the place where we work, goes to our schools, goes everywhere. What that message? The moral character. Yani Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was great in everything. In his smile, Sayyidina Anas radiallahu anhu, he said when Rasulullah smiled, yani he smiled all the time sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, cheerful face. And Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-kalimatu tayyiba, even the nice, the words you talk, consider an act of sadaqah, charity. There is someone went to Alim, he's a very poor man. He said, Ya Sheikh, I have no money to give away. The Sheikh said, yes, brother, you have. He said, what? What I have? He said, your face. Just smile in the face of people that consider sadaqah. And Sayyidina al-Mustafa, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is not only the quality who smile in the face of believers, no. When he went to Mecca after many years, and you know Ahl Mecca, what they have done to him. They want to kill him. They kill his Sahaba. They kill his people. They sold them as slaves. They took their properties. And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he went, and then he left Mecca because Ahl Mecca wants to kill him. So he went to Al-Madina Al-Munawwara, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where all the people in one day believed on him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he went back after years to Mecca, this time he's a victorious. How the victorious should deal. Now we learn from him, from his akhlaq also something about if you are a victorious, what to do. When he entered there, he was looking down, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he won't see the people in his eyes and they were scared from him. He was just looking down, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Read the Sirah Nabawiyyah, the biography of Rasulullah, and you will learn more about that. Our children have to taught this all so that they understand the meaning of us as a parents. And we understand their position as children. We understand the position of teachers and students in our life and neighbors, everything. This is all in the Holy Quran and in the Sunnah of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went to in front of Ka'batullah, in al-Multazam, And they brought all Ahl Mecca, the non-believers. And he was smiling in their face, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Sayyidina Anas, I just mentioned, he said, when Rasulullah smiled, looks like the sun circulating in his blessed face, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Riwayat al-Imam, how beautiful face. And you know, the smile will add extra beauty to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it's a beauty for all the Muslims to have this cheerful face all the time to follow the example of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he gathered all of them in front of him, and he said, and the smile in his blessed face sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to them, what do you think I am going to do today to all of you? After all what I've suffered and my people because of you, what do you think I'm going to do tonight, today? They said, Akhun Kareem, wa ibn Akhin Kareem. Ya Rasulullah, yani, you are a generous brother, son of generous brother, merciful brother, son of merciful brother. And the smile, when they saw him smiling, the message have reached already. Many years, they were his enemy. In that dialogue of few minutes, and they said, you are a generous. You know how to deal with evil deed, with what? With good deeds. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in many ahadith, he said, خالق الناس بخلق حسن وأتبع السيء الحسن تمحها. Deal with the people in good moral character and follow the bad deeds with good deeds, so it will erase it, whether it's come from you or from others. So in a smile in his face, he said to them, go, all of you forgiving. Alhamdulillah, I forgive all of you. That beautiful words came from his mouth with a beautiful smile, made all the people say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. The hearts which have full hatred towards him, subhanallah, in 1 second changed to have full love towards him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is a message. Are we within this message? Are the sheikhs, are the scholars, are the followers, are we following this message? Anyone who say, I am a Muslim and Muhammadi, I follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we will say to him, show us the noble character of Rasulullah in your actions. So not only in how you pray, the message have to go out. Non-Muslims and others, they cannot see inside our masajid, and they doesn't know what that mean. But for sure, they know what the meaning of moral character, al-akhlaq. Yes, that's what we need. And therefore, we have to change ourselves first to be good in order for us to change others. I caught here a beautiful saying of Jalaluddin al-Rumi. They call him Sultan al-Hub, the king of love, because his message was love. He said, oh, everyone have chosen his way of life, chosen the way of worship, and I have chosen love. I love my salat, I love my ibadah, I love the... That's how you will understand the message clearly when you understand the meaning of Allahu Akbar, when you understand the meaning of ruku', when you understand the meaning of sujood lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Sayyidina Nabi Allah Musa alayhi salam and his brother Sayyidina Nabi Allah Harun alayhi salam to Fir'aun, who claimed he is God, he said, Ana Rabbukum al-A'la, I am your mighty God, Fir'aun. When he sent Sayyidina Musa and Sayyidina Harun, he instructing, ad'u. How are you going to invite him? He said to them, Qula lahu qawla layyina. Talk with him in a lean way. Nice words. وَلَعَلَّهُ يَذَّكَّرُ يَخْشَى. Maybe he will get remembrance. Maybe he'll have the taqwa. You have to pass the message. Don't say, no, this person won't get the message. You do your best, and Allah is the guide, subhanahu wa ta'ala, huwa al-hadi. So he said to them, deal with this person who is a non-believer, and he claim he is God. So Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam and Sayyidina Harun say, talk with him nicely. So how should we deal then with the one who say, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, the one believe in Allah? What's happening to our attitude among us nowadays? Is it pleasing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? If you want to know how to say, how to talk, what to do, see him sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Say anything that make him happy, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Say anything that makes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happy. If Rasulullah happy with what you are saying about anyone, do it. If he's not, careful about that. And if he's not happy, that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not happy as well. Imagine Sayyidina Rasulullah, Allah have sent him rahmatan to whom? He was sending mercy to whom, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? للمسلمين, للمؤمنين, للعالمين. Everyone, all living creatures in this world, Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent to them. In Ruwati al-Imam al-Bukhari, Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Uhud, Jabal Uhud, the mountain of Uhud. He said, Jabal Uhud, Jabal yuhibbuna wa nuhibbu. Mountain of Uhud is a mountain which we love and he loves us as well. Mountain. Mountain. And you remember the story of the trunk of the tree where Sayyidina Rasulullah on the top of it used to give khutbah every Jum'ah, every Friday, before they made for him the minbar. Trunk of tree, very simple, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's been cut and died long ago. And used to stand on the top of it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and give khutbah. There is a lady with her children, she made for him a minbar. Very simple minbar to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For Fakhrul Kainat to stand on top of him and give khutbah. That's his woe, his nether. So when they made the minbar for him, they push out that trunk. They put it in the side of the masjid. And they brought the minbar for him. And he stand that khutbah, that day to give the khutbah. When he started giving the khutbah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all as-sahaba heard a sound. It's a weeping, crying. They said the cry looks like a cry of mother whom she just received the news that her son passed away. Al-Ummuth, Allah, you imagine, na'udhu billah, protect us all and our children. Inshallah, if someone receive the message that his son died, can you imagine his or her situation, the father of mother? And they said, we hear that cry come from somewhere. And they realize it come from the trunk of that tree. Because Sayyidina Rasulullah left that trunk. What happened? He came down, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, went all the way to the trunk of the tree and he hugged him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Deep, yani akhi, hugged the tree until the cry stopped. So he was very sad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, if I left, it will cry until end of the life. There is one, Sayyidina al-Hasan al-Basri said, radiallahu anhu, whenever I read this story of the trunk of the tree, I cry. He said, can you imagine a trunk, dead, dry, cried when Rasulullah left him? How about ourselves? He said, how about myself? I am Muslim. I am believer. What happened to my heart? Now you see what is the beauty part of here? When anything happened, when someone cried, he's a trunk of tree cried, Rasulullah was very concerned. How about any of his ummah cry? How your connection with him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the special connection. He spent the whole night in one verse of Quran asking Allah mercy to the ummah, the whole night. And when Jibreel came down to him, why you cry, Ya Muhammad? Allah sent Jibreel, why you cry? He said, I remember my ummah. Very concerned about us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all of us. See, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to you, don't worry about them. I will be generous to them and be merciful to them. That the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, rahmatan lil alameen, very high standard and qualities of all the goodness in this world, you can see in him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Na'am, al-Habib al-Mustafa, when we celebrate him, it's not celebration of one day, but in Rabi'ul Awwal, our celebration will be increased because it brings for us the month of the birth of Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why we should remember that month? Why we should remember Monday? Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself every Monday used to fast. Ya Rasulullah, why you fast every Monday? He said, "Dalika yawmun wulidtu fi," because it's my birthday. And he never do anything from his own, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Quran, Allah mentioned to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam in the Holy Quran, Surah Ibrahim, verse 5. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Sayyidina Musa, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَى بِآيَاتِنَا وَأَنْ أَخْرِجْ قَوْمَكَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. And we certainly send Musa with our signs, saying to him, bring out your people from darknesses into the light and remind them of the days of Allah. And remind them of the days of Allah, the days where Allah showered blessings upon them. Among these days, for example, when he saved them, Bani Israel, and Sayyidina Musa from Fir'aun. And when Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered to Madinatul Munawwara, He saw Al-Yahud, they fast Monday and Thursday. And they fast Ashura, the day of Ashura. So he said, why they fast? They said, Ya Rasulullah, because they claim that that is the day where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have saved Sayyidina Nabiullah Musa alayhi salam, peace be upon him, and his people from Fir'aun. What Rasulullah said, we have the right to celebrate as well. Celebrating a day when victory, great day in their history, in their life. So Sayyidina al-Mustafa celebrated and he ordered the people to fast also. This is to show the greatness of the day where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Sayyidina Musa from Fir'aun. How about the day of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He himself used to fast every Monday, alayhi salatu wasalam. Whoever fast Monday will say, Ya akhi, you want to celebrate Mawlid? Fast Monday and say, I am celebrating Mawlid al-Rasul. Khalas. This is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to do that, alayhi salatu wasalam. When we recite Nasheed and Qasida. When we recite Dasna wa Nasheed. Why? As-Sahaba radiallahu anhum. The poet of the Prophet, Sayyidina Hassan bin Malik, Hassan bin Thabit radiallahu anhu. Sayyidina Zuhair ibn Ka'b. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Rawaha, the poets of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to stand at the minbar and describe him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They made a poem describing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we are doing what Allah please and Rasulullah please, alhamdulillah. That's what we are doing. And alhamdulillah, al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was a great example to allow them to do that. And because he feel how they feel, the love towards him sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. As-Sahaba radiallahu anhum used to wait for him when they are sitting with him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When they are sitting with him, they are thinking of the moment he's going to leave to the house and come in the next day in the morning, in the Salat Subuh. So at that period, they feel how they're going to spend the night without watching him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, without being in his presence sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let As-Sahaba talk, let them inform us about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu have served Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for 11 years. 11 years he got the barakah and the honor to serve al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, he have not said to me a single time no. He never said no. Can you imagine how he apologized, how polite he apologizes sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Now, many number of times in our life, we say, how many number of times in one day we say no? How many? Someone offer me something? No, thank you. See, no. But Sallina Rasulullah, he won't say no even. You know how to, in a very polite way, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, full of akhlaq, full of moral character, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? He's following the Quran al-Kareem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wa qulu lin-nasi husna. Talk nicely with the people. He followed the Quran when Allah sent him. ادعو الى سبيل ربك بالحكمه. Invite to the path of your Lord with what? With hikmah, wisdom, to choose the words, to know how to talk, when to talk, with whom to talk, and why to talk, when to talk and when to stop. بالحكمه والموعظه الحسنه. I wanted to highlight this, الحسنه, the lean, the good talk, the best of way of talking. بالموعظه وجادلهم. And there's any argument, بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَن. Be the best, be the nicer in your argument as well. Who the one who taught him that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ صلى الله عليه وسلم. There is an incident happen. For example, as a Muslims, whenever we meet anyone, assalamu alaikum, correct? That is Allah instructs, assalam, our peace, assalam everywhere, peace everywhere. Greeting salam, enter your house, meeting people. When you recite Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. When you start Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. These beautiful meanings. There is someone who was working in a frozen food factory. And then, you know, that day, Friday evening, before he go back home, he entered to one of the freezers, which minus 14, the temperature. But when he entered, the door closed. We cannot go out. Because you have to open from outside. Now how to go out? The problem. So he was thinking that Friday, Saturday, Sunday, until Monday. It took from him 1 or 2 hours for him to be frozen. Khalas, gone. So while he was thinking about the horrible moment that he died on, the door opened, subhanAllah. Then he saw what?
the keeper of the factory, the guard. You know, outside the guard when the people, you know. He came and opened the door and said, brother, how you know I am here? He said, you know, brother, wherever you enter every day to factory, in your entrance, when you enter, you come to see me and say, Salaamu Alaikum. When you go out, also you say, Salaamu Alaikum. Uh-huh. So today you said, Salaamu Alaikum, enter, but I didn't see you coming out to say, he won't miss anyone else, only this one. So I know that you're still inside. I came in search of you. Allahu Akbar. وَقُولُوا لِلَّهِ حُسْنًا. These words have saved him. Salaamu Alaikum. So how many number of times say Assalamu Alaikum, and do we know the meaning of Assalamu Alaikum in the first place? You see, all of us came here from different and various cultures. Alhamdulillah, first of all, from our host, Jazakumullah Khair, Bosnia. Bosnia, I know little about them, but the little I know is I consider it very rich, because they are true muhibbin, and they are Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, and they known as followers of Tariqah, Alhamdulillah, as Imam said, and they have suffered a lot. They have suffered a lot. You know what has happened. But Alhamdulillah, one thing always remain in their heart. Anything happens, subhanAllah, the love will always increase. That is a sign of Iman. May Allah include us in that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. From Pakistan, from India, from Sri Lanka, from Malaysia, from Indonesia, from Singapore, from Bangladesh. I don't know what I'm sorry if I'm not mentioning any other countries, so forgive me. But all of us here joining, talking in one language. One language is not Abakabar or Kese or no. We are all here joining one language. This is the love of Sayyidina al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Chinta Rasul, PR of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is some Afghanistan. Sorry, brother, I didn't mention it. Naam, what is our message, brothers, sisters? Allah send us a Quran. Al-Quran send us in. It's not only sent Quran, but the way Al-Quran been sent in the interpretation and passing the message of Quran to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not like anyone. Someone maybe when he argues, say, Allah says in Quran like that. He say, wait a minute, brother. First of all, the way you are preaching is wrong. Not like Rasulullah. You be like Rasulullah when he passed the message and how he know. You have to understand that. You say, you have to understand so how soft heart he has, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That he said, when he's an imam in salah, he wants to make it long. What he do? He make it shorter because he hear the cry of the baby. He say, I know how the mother felt. How did she feel the torture? So he make it short, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He have a feeling, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The great feeling, alayhi salatu wasalam. So we need to know how to pass the message. What is the message? Read the Quran. Al-Quran tells us everything. In Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 136. Please, I hope that you can record this. So that in the future, you can relate to them. This information is very important for all of us. Like someone mentioned about Mawlid al-Rasul, the celebration of Milad, why with this one, how to deal with Muslim, non-Muslim. We need to have it with us all the time. So others will understand the message and they will love this message, inshallah. Example, in Surah Al-Baqarah 136, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قولوا آمنا بالله وما أنزل إلينا وما أنزل إلى إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق ويعقوب والأسباط وما أوتي موسى وعيسى وما أوتي النبيون من ربهم لا نفرق بين أحد منهم ونحن له مسلمون. What that mean? Listen carefully to this beautiful verse of Quran. Say, O believers, Allah. Say, O believers, we have believed in Allah. And what has been revealed to us and what has been revealed to Ibrahim, Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, and the descendant, and what has been given to Moses and Jesus, and what has given to the prophets from their Lord. We make no distinction between any of them, and we are Muslims in submission to him. This is our message. The message to believe in all the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and their messages. Part of our arkanul iman. Al-iman billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi. Wa bil yawm al-akhir qadr khayrish. It's enough for any Muslim. Whoever is he. Even if he's hafiz al-Quran. Even if he go every year to Hajj. Even if he pray five times in Mecca. It's enough for him to say, I don't believe in Yunus alayhi salam. He's out of Islam immediately. Why? Our religion asks us to believe in the messages when we are not asking someone who entered to Islam to leave his belief. No, to increase his belief in fact, to know more about Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, to know more about Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, to know more about Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. Our deen is a deen of mercy, because our prophet is a prophet of mercy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are very, very lucky to be the followers of Sayyidina Muhammad. And what else? You know, that's all. We talk about this life, but in Akhirah, you will know the value and the position of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When all the people running here and there, they go to Sayyidina Adam, they go to our prophets, they will join us searching. When they come to Rasulullah, he will ask shafa'a for all of us, inshaAllah. But how to be with him? As Sahaba, when they ask him, Ya Rasulullah, how about Judgment Day, Yawm al-Qiyamah? And he asked that Sahabi, what you have prepared for that? He said, the love of Allah and Rasulullah in my heart and in my practices. Sayyidina Rasulullah said, you are with the one whom you love. Anta ma'a man ahbabt. Sayyidina Anas, he said, beside Islam, the greatest news I've received after Islam is the words of Rasulullah, you will be with the one whom you love. We love him and we want to be with him, inshaAllah. We don't want to be in any part of Jannah. No, we want to be in Jannah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May this celebration, may this love, what we are presenting here will bless us, inshaAllah, to be close to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to celebrate him in a better way, in a best way. Bring the message back, the Seerah Nabawiyyah. Wherever you celebrate, they have to be a message about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Bring that message to you all, to your household, to your family. Inform them about this beautiful message. Let them also share it with others. We need to have these qualities in our life so that our children, inshallah, new generation, will be in good quality. There is an incident happened in Paris about a lady. She took her son to masjid. And the son went to the imam of the masjid. You know what he asked the imam of masjid? He said to him, Ya Imam, I want to be Muslim. So make me Muslim. He's a young boy. He said, why you want to be a Muslim? He said, because my mother sent me to you to make me a Muslim. He said, where is she now? He said, she's outside the mosque. So he went to her and he met the mother. He said, sister, you ask him to? She said, yes. And are you a Muslim? She said, no. Then why you want your son to be a Muslim? He said, you know, every day when I see our neighbors, their children go to school, they kiss the hand of their mother and they hug their mothers. And when they come back home, they do the same. And I saw how they treat their mothers. I want the same to happen to me from my children, and I don't want my life to end in old folks' home. I want the children to look after me as a mother, to know the value of me. That's why I've sent my son to you. She like what in Islam now? This moral character, this beautiful connection between mothers and children. Do we have these qualities nowadays? What are we feeding our children? It's a duty for us to give them food, to give them clothes, to provide them with education. Yes, but how about akhlaq? How about how to deal with others? How to sit? How to eat? How to produce? How to give something to others? I don't want to take much of your time. So what time is Maghrib? 8 o'clock. So shall we just continue a little few more minutes, inshallah? Bole, inshallah? Mushkinnay? Anyway, I will continue when you say no. Okay. Beautiful message. I always like this message. It's happened in our life. We just bring something now in our life. There is one mother. She always, of course, when she sent her son to school, young boy, she provide him with food, you know, for him to eat. But she noticed that whenever he come back home, he's very hungry. And he eat, you know, he jumped to the kitchen immediately, to the, you know, to eat. So she thought maybe the food is not enough. She provided him. She gave him extra. Then he, same thing happening. No change. So she thought maybe sick. Anyway, when the parents meeting happened, she went to the school. The teacher, the principal, said to her, sister, you know, your son is the best. She said, oh, degrees. And she said, no, this one got high degree, low, everyone can get all. But your son, he has something to do every day. She, what is that? said, you know the food you provide him? He will go himself and give it to those whom they are in need for food. He give everything, everything. He won't keep anything for him. That's something great or not? This is our deen. Ask us to share. Zakat is must. You have to share. Sadaqah must. Khairat is must. Here. So she went back home and she said to her son, listen to this. She said, why you never tell me? She was very happy, of course. Imagine the principal said the same thing to you. Your son very clean. When he used the bathroom, he's very clean. How he talk with the teacher, he's very nice. He's very polite. That's what we know. This is quality. This is akhlaq. That's how Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do. When someone talk in his presence, he won't interrupt him. He will just look to him until he finish. And then he will talk. He won't interrupt him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like what we do nowadays, unfortunately. Anyway, so she said to her son, my boy, why you never tell me about that? You know what he said? He said, mother, if I tell you, my reward between me and Allah will be gone. Allah. Ajeeb, ya akhi. What type of beautiful. Other one, the mother always said to him every day, my son, before you sleep, read 10 times, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ أَلْمُعَوُّذَةٍ قُلْ أَوْ رَبِّ الْفَلَقُ. That's what we teach our children to be protected. One day that boy, she always, she asked him to do that. He said to her, mother, why I should do that? Why I should read قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ? Huh? 10 times and why? She said to him, if you do so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you and build for you a palace in paradise, in Jannah. You know what the boy said to his mother? He said, okay, mother, I will do that, but in one condition. He said to her, I will read every day 10 times, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ, but please, mother, you don't read. Only me. She said, why? He said, because if I read قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ 10 times, Allah build palace for me. And if you read 10 times, Allah build palace for you. Then in Jannah, you will live separately. I want you to live in my palace, in fact. So what type of love and connection? Ya akhi ajeeb. This is a message. We have to pass this message to our children. Feeding them, clothing them is, yes, education. But there is moral character. If you win the way you want to be the best, you have to be the best in everything. In yourself, in a cleanness, in dealing with others, at the masjid, at home, everywhere. That is a message of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His love is there. His barakah is there, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, to inspire us to get more about his akhlaq, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. More to adopt of his akhlaq, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to pass it to others. May he subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all with barakah and rahmah fi dunya wal akhirah. I would like to say the end, a very beautiful saying by one Turkish scholar. Very nice. His name Uthman Nuri Tobas. In his book, The Exemplar Beyond Compare, Rasulullah al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, there are great personalities who make those in their presence feel small. You see, when you feel he is great, like you are small, someone who's talking, you know? There are great personalities who make those in their presence feel small. However, the greatest personalities is the one who's in his presence, people feel great. And he said, the one who used to do that is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he see a sahaba, when he talk with them, when he greet them, Allah, they feel great, they are great. That was the message of Sayyidina Rasulullah. He is great, and not with sahaba, with everyone sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we ask us all how to deal with everything, with your brothers, with your sisters, with a Muslim, with a non-Muslim, with animals, with a stone, how to be everything, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, Sayyidina Imam Ali, karamallahu wajah, said something very interesting. He said, human beings are in two types. The human beings are in two types. It's either your brother in belief or your equal in humanity. You're equal in humanity or brother belief. So in both situations, we need to know how to deal with that in a proper way to represent our deen, the deen of love, the deen of mercy, the deen of forgiving. May Allah grant us, to, inshallah, to have the power of akhlaq, the power of advice, nice advice. Advice is a language which is a currency which can buy the hearts of the people. There is no other currencies can buy the hearts, only good moral character. May Allah grant us barakah fi dunya wal akhirah. May Allah bless you all, dear brothers and sisters, with purity of hearts, purity of iman, purity of dealing, purity of akhlaq, purity of love. And may He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, bless us to meet again and again in all the majalis, in all the majalis, who increase our level of taqwa and iman fi dunya, and to see that level of taqwa and iman in akhirah, inshaAllah, to be closer to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. How to do that, ya Allah? Sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim. Let us, ya Allah, follow the blessed and rightly guided people. On the top of them, Sayyidina Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his sahaba al-kiram, ahli al-bayt al-azam, wal-awliya wal-salihin, whom Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, have sent them to guide us, inshaAllah. May Allah bless us all to be among the true believers, inshaAllah. And may Allah grant us all with happiness within our families, tranquility in our houses, not to be house, but to be homes, inshaAllah. And may Allah specially grant the masjid, this is Australian, Bosnian Islamic Center, Imam Ibrahim, and all the imams here, and all the committee and community, with full barakah fi dunya wal akhirah. And jazawum Allah khair for hosting this program. We are very thankful indeed for all of you. May Allah bless all. Special thanks for all brothers who make it happen, their volunteers, and those who work with this majlis ummati, and especially brother Sajid, brother Abdul Wajid. Jazallah khair. Sajid yani sujood, inshaAllah, min ahli sujood daima. Jazallah khair, brother Javed, inshaAllah, Chaudhry. Jazallah khair. May Allah bless him all and bless them all for all what they have done. There is no reward you expect from all of us, but the reward from Allah and Rasulullah. And with that, inshallah, the reward also come to all of you. Whoever Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the day he was born is a great day. The month is a great month. His place where he lived, Mecca, is a blessed. The place where he migrated, Al-Madina, is a blessed. As-Sahaba, Al-Muhajirun, Al-Ansar, all his companion, they are blessed. All the Ummah are blessed, including the Muhibbin also, they are blessed, inshallah. All of you are great. May Allah grant us rahmah fi dunya wal akhirah. And may Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, keep us always close, inshallah, physically and spiritually, fi dunya wal akhirah. Ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. Rabbana taqabbal minna, waqbalna, warhamna, wasamihna, utub alayna, waghfir lana. Allahumma barik fil jama'ati al-hadirin wal-hadirat, walidina, walidihim, azwajana, wazwajihim, dhurriyatina, dhurriyatihim. Ya Allah, bless all brothers, sisters, their families, their children, their wife, husband and wife, parents. Ya Allah, include with rahmah, with special health for those whom they are sick. Ya Allah, bless them with speedy recovery. And for those whom they passed away, ya Allah, bless them with rahmah and shafa'atul habib Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us, ya Allah, live in this world peacefully and leave it peacefully and reach to you peacefully, inshaAllah. Rabbana taqabbal du'ana kareem. Warhamna wa barik lana fil jama'atil ahadirina wal hadirat. And whoever listening to us, ya Allah, grant us all الخير والبركة الحمنا يا رحم الراحمين ارزقنا خير الرازقين اغفر لنا خير الغافرين تقبل دعانا أجمعين وعلى هذه النية وإلى حضرة الحبيب الأعظم سيدنا رسول الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأهل بيته وأصحابه وأزواجه وذريته وقرابته وأمته أجمعين الفاتحة. رب العزة عما يصفون السلام سلم الحمد لله رب العالمين.
13 is the Maghrib. 8:13.
But she was
short. Dubai.
Normally, what we do at doing everywhere, the recitation of Mawlid, the paragraphy, Sirah Nabawiyah. But the time is very short, so we'll take about 5 minutes. Is that okay now? Just 5 minutes, so that the end will be with a remembrance also of Sayyidina Rasulullah. And we are doing that, in fact, all the time, bi'idhnillah. So we'll do that little bit of it, and salawat, which we hope that all of you can, you know, I think you're familiar, Ya Nabi Salam Alayka. There's many mawlids, books of mawlid to recite, Mawlid Barazanchi, Mawlid Diba'i, other mawlids, but today we should recite last part of Mawlid Diba'i, inshallah, together. So may Allah grant us rahmah. The dunya wal akhirah. Okay, inshallah. It's a Maghrib time. Now this is a special time for dua maqbool. Hopefully, inshallah, Allah will accept us. Bi-idhnillah. Ameen. Ya ila hadrat al-Nabi Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa al-Fatiha.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. أحضروا قلوبكم يا معشر ذوي الألباب حتى أجلو لكم عرائس معاني أجل الأحباب المخصوص بأشرف الألقاب الراقي إلى حضرة الملك الوهاب، حتى نظر إلى جماله بلا ستر ولا حجاب. فلما ناوان ظهور شمس الرسالة في سماء الجلالة خرج مرسوم الجليل نقيب المملكة جبريل، يا جبريل نادي في سائر المخلوقات من أهل الأرض والسماوات بالتهاني والبشارات، فإن النور المصون والسر المكنون الذي أوجدته قبل وجود الأشياء وابدا الارض والسماء قلوا في هذه الليله الى بطن امه مسرورا، املوا به الكون نورا، كلوا يتيما وطهره واهل بيته تطهيرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى اله. فاهتز العرش طربا واستبشارا، وازداد الكرسي هيبه ووقارا، وامتلأت السماوات أنوارا، وضجت الملائكة تهليلا وتمجيدا واستغفارا. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. ولم تزل أمه ترى أنواعا من فخره وفضله إلى نهاية تمام حمله، فلما اشتد بها الطلق بإذن رب الخلق وضعت الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم ساجدا شاكرا حامدا كأنه البدر في تمام. صلى الله على محمد الله عليه وسلم. صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا نبي سلام عليك، يا رسول سلام عليك، يا حبيب سلام عليك، صلوات الله عليك يا نبي سلام عليك، يا رسول سلام عليك، يا حبيب سلام عليك، صلوات الله أشرق الكون ابتهاجا بوجود المصطفى أحمد، ولأهل الكون أنس وسرور قد تجدد. يا نبي يا رسول سلام عليك، يا حبيب سلام عليك، صلوات الله عليك. فاطربوا يا المثاني فهزاروا اليمن غرت، واستضيئوا بجمال فاق في الحسن تفرد. يا نبي
سلام عليك.
غزال
اوكي غزال هاز جوت وان
ذس وان نوت وركينج جيف ات تو هيم ريبليس. سلام عليك، صلوات الله عليك، ولنا البشرى بسعد مستمر ليس ينفد،
حيث أوتينا عطاء جمع الفخر المؤبد يا نبي سلام عليك يا رسول سلام عليك يا حبيب سلام عليك صلوات الله عليك فلربي كل حمد جل أن يحصره العد إذ حبانا بوجودي مصطفى الهادي محمد يا نبي سلام عليك يا رسول سلام عليك يا حبيب سلام عليك صلوات الله عليك مرحبا مرحبا يا نور عيني مرحبا مرحبا جد الحسين مرحبا مرحبا نور عيني مرحبا مرحبا جد الحسين مرحبا يا رسول الله أهلا مرحبا بك إن بك نسعد مرحبا مرحبا يا نور عيني إني مرحبا وبجاهه يا إلهي مرحبا جود وبلغ كل مقصد مرحبا مرحبا يا نور عيني مرحبا مرحبا جد الحسين مرحبا واهدنا نهج سبيلي مرحبا به نسعد ونرشد مرحبا مرحبا يا نور مرحبا مرحبا سيني ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي ببركة الهادي محمد الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي ببركة الهادي محمد الله ربي بلغنا بجاهه في جوار خير مقعد الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي ببركة الهادي محمد الله وصلاة الله تغشى أشرف الرسل محمد الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي ببركة الهادي محمد الله وسلام مستمر كل حين يتجدد الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي دي محمد يا الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي ببركة ألا البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داع طلع البدر علينا الوداع وجب الشكر علينا أدع لله أيها المبعوث فينا جئت بالأمر المطاع جئت شرفت المدينة مرحبا يا خير ذا طلع الملل علينا من ثني صلي وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله. The last dua inshallah, the closing of the majlis بإذن الله. Maybe Sheikh Ibrahim can recite the dua. This one, here is it.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. جعلنا الله وإياكم ممن يستعجب شفاعته ويرجو من الله رحمته ورأفته. اللهم بحرمة هذا النبي الكريم وإلى أصحابه السالكين على منهجه القويم اجعلنا من جيار أمته واسترنا بذيل حرمته واحشرنا غدا في زمرته واستعمل ألسنتنا في مدحه ونصرته وأحينا متمسكين بسنته وطاعته وأمتنا اللهم على حبه وجماعته اللهم أدخلنا معه الجنة وإنه أول من يدخلها وأنزلنا معه في قصورها فإنه أول من ينزلها وارحمنا يوم يشفع للخلائق فترحمهما اللهم ارزقنا زيارته في كل سنة ولا تجعلنا من الغافلين عنك ولا عنه قدر سنة اللهم لا تجعل في مجلسنا هذا أحدا إلا غسلت بماء التوبة ذنوبه وسترت برداء المغفرة عيوبه اللهم إنه كان معنا في السنة الماضية إخوان رحمهم الله منعهم القضاء عن الوصول إلى مثلها
فلا تحرمهم ثواب هذه الساعة فضلها اللهم اجعلنا اللهم اجعلنا ارحمنا إذا صرنا من أصحاب القبور وفقنا لعمل صالح يبقى سناه على ممر الدهور اللهم اجعلنا لآلائك ذاكرين لنعمائك شاكرين ولو لقائك من الذاكرين وحنا بطاعتك مشغولين وإذا توفيتنا فتوفنا غير مفتونين ولا مخذولين واختم لنا منك بخير أجمعين اللهم اكفنا شر الظالمين اللهم اكفنا شر الظالمين اللهم اكفنا شر الظلم والظالمين واجعلنا من فتنة هذه الدنيا سالمين اللهم اجعل هذا الرسول الكريم الحبيب لنا شفيعا اللهم اجعل هذا الرسول الكريم الحبيب لنا شفيعا وارزقنا به وبجاهه يوم القيامة مقاما رفيعا اللهم اسقنا من حوض الكوثر حوض نبيك سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم شربة هنيئة مريئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا واحشرنا تحت لوائه غدا اللهم اغفر لنا به ولآبائنا ولأمهاتنا وللجماعة الحاضرين والحاضرات وأصحاب هذا المسجد والديهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم ولمشايخنا ومعلمينا وذوي الحقوق علينا ولمن أجرى هذا الخير في هذه الساعة ولجميع المسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم الأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات وقاضي الحاجات وغافر الذنوب والخطيئات يا أرحم الراحمين اجعلنا اللهم لآلائك من الذاكرين لنعمائك من الشاكرين وتقبل منا أجمعين وعلى هذه النية وإلى حضرة سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأهل بيته وأصحابه وأزواجه وذريته وقرابته وجميع الأولياء والصالحين والجماعة الحاضرين المسلمين والمسلمات في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها على ذي النية بسر أسرار الفاتحة الحمد لله رب العالمين صلاة المستقيم
سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على الحمد لله رب العالمين تقبل الله منكم جزاكم الله خيرا مي الله بليس يو الحمد لله
Yes, we will move now. Quickly.
Prepare for Salah.
The food is really outside on the way out.
After Salah?
Yeah, after Maghrib, we can take the food and pen. So it's all pen.
Take away.
So we'll keep the mosque clean, inshallah. Please. After Maghrib, so Maghrib, we'll take the food and leave the masjid and have your meal outside the house.
Put it.